Okay, today we're going to do another build from the film Lonely Stick of Dynamite. This one's going to be a dynamite box. We need quite a few of these. And we're going to make them from coffee stirrers that you can get in most places for nothing. Okay, we need a sharp knife and some super glue. Remember, take safety precautions when using a sharp knife and also with the super glue. Don't want to cut yourself or stick yourself together. And we're going to take four stirrers, put some super glue down the edge, and we're just going to add them together, and this will form the basis of either the sides or the lid or the bottom. When you're gluing wood together, sometimes it takes a little bit longer than plastic or other stuff because it's more absorbent. But you'll eventually get there. If it doesn't stick straight away, just let it dry a bit and then use dry glue as a basis to put your second coat on and it should stick. Once you've got four together, put them to one side. Let that dry off. We're going to need two of those with four lots of stirrers. Same thing again. There's a little chip in that one, but that doesn't matter because we're looking for rough and ready with these crates. They're meant to be quite old, bruised, whatever you want to call it. There's our two fours. Now to do the sides, there's only two on each side. And once we've glued these and they're set, we're going to cut them down to size. And we'll also need another one of these for the end pieces. On there and there. So one more double. Just wait for those to dry. Okay, so we're going to start cutting these now that they're stuck together. Again, you can be rough and ready with the sizes. We're not going for accuracy, as all the crates are around about the same size. That's good because this one's just falling apart. As you can see there, that one's falling apart from the glue, but we can still break. If you cut halfway through, you can snap it off and you get a nice rough edge on the side. We'll just put some more glue on that one. As I said, sometimes the glue doesn't really take. You have to wait until it's dried on there, put another coat, and then the glue will stick with the glue. Just match those edges up. And then just take a rough measurement using another crate. Score it halfway down and just snap off the end. And that's one of the sides complete. You just do that for all four sides. The same for the lids and the bottom part. They can be a little bit longer because the lids do overgo the actual size of the crate, so you want them slightly bigger than the sides. Okay, so then the main components, you can see there we've got two sides exactly the same, two end pieces exactly the same, two covers exactly the same, and on this one I've already added the cross beams, if you like. You know, on crates you have like bits that are nailed in to make the lid go all together, so you need four of these. I've already cut two off and fitted them, and I'll fit these two. Again, rough and ready. Don't have to be exactly in the same place. Don't have to be straight. You can have bits going over the end. You can have some of these that have got bits of wood missing. So if you wanted to, you could just run a knife down, cut a chunk out, split it off a bit, and put it on. Looks like split wood. Just keeps all the crates from, although they look the same, each one is individual. So when they're all messed together, even though they look like hundreds of crates, you can look into it and go, oh, that one's got a bit missing, that one's a little bit darker, etc, etc. So while we wait for that bit to dry, we'll start putting together the four sides. start with one piece. I usually start with an end piece. Just hold it in place until the glue takes. So once you get that first part in place, that helps the rest of it go together. Get a side piece. Hold it in place for a few seconds. Hopefully that will take. Build the rest of your crate up. Sometimes you need about four or five hands just to hold it until it's set. Okay, so once you've got your basic crate shape together, you can put on the lid, you can put it on slightly askew. Doesn't matter, like I say, rough and ready. And there you go. One crate ready to be weathered. We'll do that in another video. So I've got some other bits of wood that needs weathering, and I'll show you three or four different types of ways that you can weather these things. So that's a finished crate. Put it there next to the other one. And when you see hundreds of these together, be quite a sight, believe you me. It's a lot of work.